Hey everyone, welcome back. In this Jira Roadmap tutorial, let us quickly understand some of the more important features within Jira Basic Roadmap, how you can share the roadmap and how you can export it and share it across the team. Okay, so one very important thing in the Jira Basic Roadmap is about the epic colors, right? So basically at the moment, if you see, all of these colors are same. So it's good if we have a different color coding for these epics, right? So say for example, I want to change the color for this one, simply select it, and from the catalog here, so basically from the icon, just click on it, and these are the available colors. So we'll choose some different colors so that you can easily and your team can easily identify the different issues or different epics and the color combination based on that. Okay, so let me finish it and then we will. Okay, so now if you see, we have different colors for the epic. So this is quickly about the color coding and combination or changing the colors, right? Then moving it across, changing the timeline, it's pretty easy. If you have the dependency and there is a epic which moves basically ahead of, or you want to start that ahead of the issue that gets finished. So because there is a dependency of this epic on the previous one, you'll see that this dependency detail will change to red. Right, so you have to make sure that your dependencies are managed properly by dragging these work items accordingly on the timeline. Okay, so that's about the changing the color and moving or updating the dependencies accordingly. Now in the view settings, you can check and uncheck the dependency. So if you uncheck the dependency, the arrows will go away. You can check and uncheck the progress, right? So it will basically, so here if you see, if a progress is checked, you will see the progress of the statuses or the issues that are happening within this particular epic. If say for example there are five epics or five issues below that, half of them are complete, you will see the color code of this progress bar happens accordingly. Okay, and then in the refine view, you have epic display option. So you have, you know, either you can choose either complete, all, or incomplete. So depending, you know, if I say complete, there are no epics that are completed, so it won't display anything, right? So I'll choose to all. This is some of the filter options. Then in order to share this whole roadmap, you have this share button, right? So click on share and you can specify the name, right, or team or email, right? So say for example, I have a teams created in Jira, so I can specifically select the team or individual users, or I can specify the email directly. Okay, so say for example, this is the user that I want to share the details to, or this particular, so I can, you know, keep entering the name and then the names will appear, and then I can basically go ahead and send. I can specify the message, or I can copy the link and share the link with the team. If they have access to Jira, they'll be able to see this particular roadmap. Okay, this is about the sharing. Then exporting is another very good feature that I found, because in the projects we have this wall, right? So the project wall as such, where everyone wants to see, or the visual representation. So not every time people will be opening the Jira or having a look at it, right? So when you export this whole roadmap as an image and put it at the project wall, at a project space in your organization, then everyone has a clear picture of what all epics we are working towards, and then which epics are basically dependent on which one, and how we are progressing overall in terms of the progress. So the project team or the higher level stakeholders can directly come and discuss across the board by using this particular image. Okay, so you can export this, print it out, and then have it on the project board at your project space within the organization. Okay, so this is another good feature of exporting this overall roadmap. Okay, then you have the week view, month view, and quarters view. So we are in the quarters view. You can change it to month view or the weeks view, which will give you more granular picture of the work item and how the dependencies are and how the work will progress, right? So this is sort of a brief about the basic roadmap. There is not much, it is still a very strong feature as such for the team, within the team. If you want to have the team level roadmap being defined and manage the work just within the team, basic roadmap is good enough. But when you go across the team at the portfolio level, when you have multiple teams, you have to either rely on the pro version of Jira, wherein I'll cover the pro version, and you will get the Jira advanced roadmap, which will cover a lot of more features there, and or you have to rely on some of the apps, which I'll also cover. There are very good apps available, which I'll cover in coming tutorial. So that's all about the Jira Basic Roadmap. In the next tutorial, we'll start with the Jira Advanced Roadmaps. I hope this was helpful. Thank you very much for watching.